Welcome to the Sunday Reach by Dominicans in India. Dear brothers and sisters, today is the first Sunday of Lent, and the Mother Church wants us to reflect upon the temptation of Jesus. As we begin, let me reflect upon one of the poems that made a strong impression on me during my graduation. It was of Robert Frost's Road Not Taken. The deep meaning of this poem is in fact worth meditating upon as we begin our reflection today. He begins the poem saying, "Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler, long I stood." Then he goes on to explain the features of these two roads. One was grassy and not very clear, because not many have traveled by that road, while the other was well kept because many have traveled by that road. Then Frost concludes the poem saying, "Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference." Human beings are gifted with freedom. And due to the fact that we are free, choices are part of our life. These choices we make knowingly or unknowingly on the daily basis. The most fundamental choice that we have to make is between good and evil. It is here that devil plays his trick. The best example for this we read in the book of Genesis. The devil in the form of a serpent presents the fruit that was forbidden by God as the most desirable thing. The serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So far they did not eat it, but now that it is presented differently by the serpent, they eat, and thus commit the first sin of disobedience. In the gospel of the day too, we see Jesus confronted with the same difficulty. Jesus also had choice, and devil worked at that choices. We see three levels of choices Jesus faced. Firstly, choice between body and soul. Here it is not that one is bad and the other is good. Rather, it is about which of these should be preferred first. Jesus says that we need to give more importance to the spiritual life of ours and not just the bodily desires alone. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Jesus chose not to immediately gratify the physical hunger, though he could do that instantly. Second, choice between power and service. Jesus says, "I have come to serve and not to be served." He served everyone, the sick, the lame, the poor, the blind. He even washed the legs of his disciples and asked them to do likewise. It is through this service that he attracted people to himself. But at the beginning of his ministry, he was once confronted with this choice of being the greatest of all or being the least and servant of all, and he chose the latter. Thirdly, choice between world and God. The third choice that he had to make was between gaining the world by worshipping the devil or gaining God by being obedient to him. Psalmist says, "The earth is the Lord's and all it contains, the world and those who dwell in it." Therefore, those who choose this world and the prince of this world, thinking that they would get everything, will be disappointed, because devil has nothing but false promises to offer. He is the prince of lies. To God alone belongs all the riches and power. Jesus says to the devil, "Therefore, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him shall you serve." In all these choices, Jesus chose the best. He chose soul over body, he chose God over the world, and he chose service over power. St. Augustine says, Jesus gave into temptation not only to become our aid, but also an example. He thus teaches us that to sin is to pitch the desires of the flesh over the desires of spirit, to pitch the desire for this world against desire for God, and to have the desire for power over others against the call to serve others. We too face with similar choices in our life. This battle of temptation is always before us. According to Saint Gregory, there are three stages in this battle of temptation: suggestion, delight, and consent. Suggestion to do bad come to us as it came to Jesus. Jesus stopped with the suggestion, but we sometimes go into take delight in the suggestions that come to us and even give consent to it. Therefore, Mother Church urges her children to keep three important observances: fasting, prayer, and almsgiving during the season of Lent. Fasting, so that I may choose soul over body. Prayer, so that I may choose God over the world. And almsgiving, so that I may choose to serve others than have power and dominions over them. This is a road less traveled, and all who travel this road make a difference. Amen.